गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द कॉन्सेप्ट एंड द नेम ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट इज पोल्स ऑफ अ मैग्नेट। व्हाट डू मीन बाय पोल्स ऑफ अ मैग्नेट? लेट अस स्टार्ट इट विद एन एक्टिविटी एंड द एक्टिविटी इज समथिंग लाइक दिस दैट देयर इज अ मैग्नेट। ओके, वी हैव टेकन अ बार मैग्नेट एंड वी पुट सम टेक सम iron fillings in a bowl okay some iron fillings have been taken in it iron fillings I hope you know what are iron fillings are just like crushed iron or you can say scrape of the iron okay and when we put this magnet in the iron then what we observe that maximum of the iron fillings they get stick to the two parts okay when this magnetic bar is kept in the iron fillings what do we observe that it has iron fillings all around it but the density or the quantity of the iron filling is maximum on the ends this region contains maximum of the iron fillings clear so what does it mean these two parts they are covered with iron fillings it means that the most of the iron fillings they are clinging or they are sticking to the ends of the bar magnet so what you conclude from this that these particular parts of the magnet they attract or they have maximum magnetic bars okay means magnetic strength is mostly on the ends of the magnet okay and these are not sticking here in lot of quantity they are attracted towards the magnet unevenly means lots and lots of here on both the ends and very less in the center okay so these regions where most of the this is a let me write down what is it magnet bar these are iron fillings okay f I not double l single I l iron fillings okay this is a bowl in which we have taken the iron fillings clear now what is the conclusion of this activity that the regions of the magnet where most of the iron fillings are sticking these particular parts are known as poles of the magnet these are called poles of the magnet okay so it means that magnetic force is maximum on poles fine these magnetic forces are maximum or stronger at the poles of the magnet clear now let us see some more things about it when we suspend a magnet suppose this is a magnet and I am suspending it with the help of a thread okay or a string then it is suspended freely okay and it is going to keep on moving for some time after some time it is going to align itself it will become stable okay so how it is going to become stable and where it will become stable it is going to align itself in north-south direction of the earth. Okay, north-south direction. It means that the end that is pointing towards the north is known as North Pole, and the one which is pointing towards the south is called South Pole. Okay, so let us again see this. The magnet has two poles, as we have observed in this activity. So, how to find out that which one is North Pole and which end is called South Pole? Okay, suppose the magnet is like this. So, the one Earth, how Earth appears? Earth is divided into two parts. This is called equator. So upper part is north, lower part is south, and this side lies east and here west. Okay, so you have learnt about the axis. So this pole from where the axis, that imaginary line, is passing out of the earth, this is called North Pole and this one is called South Pole. So direction wise, okay, so direction wise, the alignment of the magnet which shows the end towards North Pole is called North Pole, and the one which is directing in south direction is called South Pole. Okay, so like this we can give the names or which direction they are pointing in geographically. Earth, when observed geographically, this is geographically means directionally. Okay, so directionally North and South Pole. So this property of a magnet is called its directional property. What do we call it? Directional property means because it is telling about the direction of the it is aligning itself according to the direction. So we call it directional property. Clear? So this is how we are going to give the names of the poles of a magnet, North Pole or South Pole. Okay? So this is called, these are called the poles of a magnet. Now we are going to start with another thing, that the concept of attraction and repulsion between and repulsion between magnets. Okay, so what does it mean? See, the like poles, let us make one diagram. North Pole and South Pole in a magnet. Okay, this is North, this is South. Fine. Now, if we keep a magnet in this condition, North and South, then what is going to happen? They both are going to attract each other. Okay, but if we keep, these are unlike poles. Okay, the condition is unlike poles are in front of each other. Now let us see another condition. This is North, this is South. This is South, this is North. Okay, now what is going to happen? They are going to push each other. Not attract each other. They are not going to pull each other, but push each other. Okay, like two poles. Let us take the two magnets. This is North, this is South. This is North, this is South. So if I keep the magnets like this, they are going to attract each other. Okay, but if I reverse them, like this was north, this was south. Now this is south, this is north. So if I am going to bring near to each other, they are not going to, they are going to push each other. So what you are going, you might have experienced also, when you bring two like poles in front, they will push like this, this way or this way, but not like this. And if you are going to force them to stick to each other, then also they are going to slip and not at all attract. Okay, so this is happening between either like this condition, or if I keep like this, south, north, and south, north, then also they are going to push each other. Okay, so these are like poles. So unlike poles always show attraction, while like poles always show repulsion. See, if you remember, we have used the word magnetic force. So magnetic force can be attractive, it can be repulsive. Fine. So attraction, force, what do you mean by force? Push or pull. So when attraction is there, it means they are pulling each other, they are trying to attract each other. So pull, magnetic pull. But when repulsion is taking place, then what is happening? It is push. They are trying to push each other. Okay. So this is how we can tell about the attraction and repulsion between the magnets. So when it means when two unlike poles, they are face to face each other, then they are going to attract, they are going to pull each other. But when like poles are there, like south south, or sorry, this is reverse, north and south, then what will happen? South south, they are going to push each other. North north, then they are going to push each other. Okay, so the like poles, they repel each other, repulsion or attraction. Fine. So this is how we can tell about the behavior of poles when they are face to face each other. If they are unlike, when they are like poles. Okay, so unlike poles are going to attract each other, opposite poles are going to attract each other, while like poles are going to repel each other. So this is how we can tell about the attraction and repulsion between magnets. Fine. So this was about attraction and repulsion between the magnets. So I hope you have understood what we had learnt in this concept. Fine.